Pastor Joel Gottesman from the Bridge Church. I pray that this word will be a word in season, that it may bring blessing and encouragement to your life. I pray that this would cause your faith to grow. The Bible says that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. I pray that you will sit back and enjoy.
Oh, have a day. Oh, a happy day. Oh, have a day. When Jesus washed. Oh, when he washed. Oh, when Jesus washed. When Jesus washed. When Lord washed. He washed my sins away. Oh, happy day. Oh, happy day.
Hi, Pastor Joel and Pastor Sandra. We just wanted to say it has been a pleasure and a privilege serving under your ministry. We truly believe in your vision and where you are leading us to.
We have been with you since you were a youth pastor, and we have had the opportunity of working with you and being under your guidance. Though at times we were a little stubborn, you have seen us grow up.
I remember 7 years ago when we were a small neighborhood church and when we were on the move, even when we entered Bill Dollar's store, and not able to see what it is today. A small group of people has turned into three services.
I'm excited because we have seen part of your vision come to life, and we are anxious to see where you will lead us to next. We love you.
Good morning, Pastor Joel, Pastor Sandra. God bless you and your family. My name is Greg Rodriguez. This is my wife, Janie. And this morning, we just want to share a little bit about how we got to the Bridge Church. We've been here 4 years. October 5th of this year was our fourth anniversary here at the Bridge Church. And we loved every minute of it. We'd like to share our testimony about how we got here. 4 years ago, we weren't saved, but we were attending this place called Our Father's House. I was at the verge of flipping over, I guess you want to call it. But anyway, we would go to this place every Tuesday, and this day, particular day, we weren't going to go, but whatever, I think I was tired. I just didn't feel like going, so I called my wife, told her I wasn't going, so we were not to go. But I was going home, I was driving, and I had to pass right by it, and all of a sudden I just turned into the church and called my wife and told her, I'm going to go after all. You want to come by? I'll be there. So she did arrive, and when she got there, that's the first day we encountered our pastor, Pastor Joel. As soon as we heard him preach, man, we just looked at each other and I said, wow. And the reason we were surprised like that was because, and we've been looking for a church, you know, because that place where we're going is not a church. It was just a place that we meet every Tuesday and worship God or encounter the Holy Spirit. Anyhow, we looked at each other, and as soon as they finished preaching, you know, we asked them where they were from. They said they were from Robstown. And I said, wow, because the whole time, I mean, we would get up every Sunday and go to church, go to, you know, nearby churches, and we park and we watch everybody go in, we even go eat. We just couldn't get off and attend that church. So, you know, we just we just strongly believe that our encounter with our pastors there at that place was God. You know, God, you know, if he hadn't turned me to go to that direction, I wouldn't have met him, because that's the only time he ever preached at that place. So we strongly believe that it was God. So we're here because of God. Anyway, that was our encounter, and coming here to the Bridge Church, and I remember that day very, very well, you know. But just by me looking at my wife, she looking at me, and I said, wow, this is it. This is the guy we need. And when he told us that it was at Rasta, I said, wow, man. He was so close, but yet so far, you know, the whole time he was here, and we didn't know about it. But I said, we've been very blessed, coming here. The pastor has taught us so many things about God, about what we have to do to receive the blessings that God has for us. And the most important thing was how to give back to God, you know, what was his, because I didn't understand that factor. When they told me that I had to give 10% of my money to God, you know, I thought, what? You need to prove it to me now, buddy. I mean, it wasn't the pastor telling me, it was just somebody else that told me, when I told him I was going to go to church, and I said, are you ready to give your 10%? I said, what are you talking about? Anyhow, he taught us that the meaning of that and why we have to do it, and you know what? It works. Pastors mean the world to us, you know. We wouldn't trade them for nothing. There ain't nothing out there that could, you know, just lead us away from this church, because, you know, first of all, we're strong believers that God brought us here. And I've learned to obey God and do the things that God asked me to, because if I don't, man, you can be ugly. You can be very mean, you know. So it's real simple. Just follow the Bible, you know. Follow the teachings that the pastor gives us, and you'll be okay. But we're thankful for that. We've been a lot happier ever since we turned ourselves to the Lord and had this church here. Our lives changed 360 degrees, man, because it was heading in the wrong direction. For us to be able to come to a place and be accepted, you know, with open arms, and that's what we experienced the very first day we got here, man. I understand at the time, you know, the Holy Spirit, but I experienced it that first day that I was here, not knowing back then what that really was, you know, but knowing now what it was, I know it was the Holy Spirit that grabbed me, you know. That was because how we were accepted here. Everybody was friendly and helpful, and we just felt like the family, man. And you know, that's basically how we started here 4 years ago. Just glad God was thinking of me.
I just want to give thanks to the Lord, and I want to bless the Lord because of him. That's why we're here. Because of him, we met them. It's God. It was all God that sent us to him. And ever since then, we've been so blessed. And I would never go somewhere else. Because I love my pastor so much. My pastor Sandra, pastor. I love him with all my heart because they've always been there for us. Since the first day we met him, I saw the light when I met him that day, that night. I saw a light because I was going through a very, very ugly depression at that time. I was like in a darkness, real ugly darkness. And as soon as I walked in, that I saw him and I saw Pastor Sandra and Pastor, it was like I had seen a light,
a light.
Yes, I praise God. And then we met and then they invited us to their church. The next day, there was going to be a Wednesday, we came in. As soon as I walked in those doors inside the church, it was like I felt the presence of God. I felt this Holy Spirit in me. I never had felt that before in my life since that day. And ever since then, we've been coming to the church. We're members here. We've been here 4 years.
Right? The most awesome things that I've seen the pastor do is work in faith, man. And this guy has faith.
They're wonderful pastors.
Without faith, he'd be broke.
when my dad was sick in the hospital before he died, they would always go visit my dad at the hospital. He was there in his fernal. He was he gave up preaching, brother. He preached there at the fernal. And when Brother Greg was in the hospital, they were always there praying, the whole church, and especially Pastor and Pastor Sandra. And they always been there. That's why I love my pastors so much.
We love you guys. God bless you. Enjoy your day.
Invited to the Bridge Church by vision partners that lived in our city, and what caught our attention was the enthusiasm that they had when they spoke about the Bridge Church, this church out of Robstown, Texas. So we decided that we would attend a cell group, and we were impressed with the cell group enough to come one Wednesday evening to the Wednesday service. And we like that. At the time, Pastor Joel was on vacation. He was on a cruise. So we actually didn't see him for about 2 weeks. But the associate pastor, Pastor Ronnie, we could tell he was a man of God, humble of heart, with a great spirit-filled message. And it kept us coming back. Eventually, Pastor Joel and Pastor Sandra came back. And the first Sunday that they were back, I was very impressed with the boldness in which he delivered the message, and we knew that this was certainly a home as far as church that we were looking for. And continually, week after week, we were impressed with, again, the boldness and the lack of fear in the message, especially in a region of Texas where religion seems to be predominant rather than relationship with Jesus. And I know since about 2000, we've been looking for a church that gave us the relationship that we used to have in a previous church that we were at. So that it kind of really hit home with us, and we knew that this was where we wanted to be. We wanted to be among other Christians and other people who had no fear, boldly proclaimed the word and the love of Jesus and what he did for us. And we have been blessed ever since. In the time that we've become vision partners, we've gotten to know the pastors and really have gotten to socialize with them quite a bit, and we've invited them out, they've invited us out, and we've gladly actually come together in spirit of Christians to worship, to break bread, and to just have fun. And what I enjoy about the church, or what we enjoy about the church, is that many other churches that are spirit-filled, getting to the pastor and spending time with the pastors is a very difficult thing. Another member, church member, vision partner, and one of the pastors, we were out swimming, and I said, what other church can we go and where the pastor comes and swims with us? I don't think John Hagee would be swimming with us. And the other person said, well, not without a shirt on, he wouldn't. So it was, but it's true. This is a down-to-earth church, and you think about Jesus, and he was approachable. And not that I have anything against other churches, but some of the pastors, you need to set an appointment months in advance to see them. And here it's not that way. And that's the way Jesus had it. He was approachable, he was open, and in many ways it's led us to fulfill what I think are our callings in ministry that God has for us. So we're doing things within the church, and they've given us the freedom to express our talents, to use us and fulfill the ministries that we have. We don't believe that it's an accident that we're here. We think that destined for us by God, and everything seemed to fall in place that the right time, the right people approached us, and we were in the right frame of mind that we wanted and needed a church like this, and especially pastors like this that can minister to us yet be friends to us as well. And that's something that so many people here don't have, and it really makes me appreciate the relationship that I have with Christ, and understand that we don't have a religion, we have the relationship, and it makes me want to, for us, makes us want to go out and show other people you can have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, as opposed to a religion that says, kneel, stand, bow. And it's a very special thing, and we're boldly proclaiming and expecting good things and growth in this church from Robstown, Texas.
My perspective would probably be from more of an emotional woman's perspective. We moved down here 6 years ago from Austin. Austin has a number of big, good churches, and I felt like we had moved to a spiritual wasteland. We had attended a church in Corpus, but we were looking at a one-hour drive each way, so we felt very limited in our involvement, you know, being so far away. We had some very serious issues in our relationship that had occurred, and I think we were both just really feeling stressed and getting to the end, and our neighbor came over and invited us, and I had expressed to him that, you know, I need a church. We needed other Christians. We needed some kind of involvement. And he came to our door, and they wanted people to come to their cell group. They were inviting people from Orange Grove, come have a free meal, fellowship, you know. And it was just an answer to a prayer. That was the first step. We knew nothing about the church or Robstown. We attended the cell group, and from there we did come and we attended the church. And it was just really an answer to a prayer, because we knew when we walked in here, I mean, it's so spirit-filled and so dynamic, and there's no crossing the line. I mean, Pastor Joel stands very firm in what he feels, and it's obvious that he's very led by God, and he stretches you. He expects you to get out there and to get out in the community and to bring people into the church, which for me is a real stretch. I've never done that type of thing. But it's my responsibility as a Christian to help other people come to God. And I've got to grow and get comfortable with that. And this church, seeing the people here and how friendly and warm and open they were, you know, drew me in. And so it makes me want to draw other people in, because, I mean, that's what we're here for, is to get people saved. Our relationship has improved tremendously. And I believe that's being under the leadership of Pastor Joel and being around other Christians within the church and seeing strong relationships and strong marriages. You know, it encourages us to continue to try, to know we're not perfect. Pastor Sandra is such a delightful person. From the very first time that I met her, the eye contact, the sincerity, the warmth that just emanates from her. She always makes us feel very welcome, and she always tries to visit with everyone, including my daughter, my 17-year-old daughter, you know, engaging her in conversation and drawing her out and making her feel like she's at home, making her feel very comfortable. We've had the privilege of spending time with Pastor Sandra and Pastor Joel as well, and I've just never experienced a pastor's wife who just really so sincere, so real, has time for you, never makes you feel like, I'm in a hurry to be somewhere, what do you need? You know, she comes and she just makes you feel very comfortable and very at home. And you can see that it's affected everybody because we see it throughout the church with all the other members of the church as well. She's just delightful. She really is.
I think the spiritual lessons that we've learned from Pastor Joel and Pastor Ronnie have really blessed us in our lives, not only in our home, but in business as well. A few months back, Pastor Joel gave us the opportunity to give, to sow into the kingdom, and what we've reaped from that has just been incredible. The money that we gave turned around, and in my profession, I know that $1.2 million was given to one of my clients without even being asked for by the state. And through that, we're able to help 60 kids that are in trouble or that are problem children within the Houston area. So that's something that I believe has evolved from this. The other clients that I have in my business also, things have just taken off in anything that I've been involved with. And while I don't monetarily profit from that negotiation, it makes me look real good. And of course, then other clients will come in and hire me to do other things, on top of receiving another contract that has tremendously boosted our income.
And it was at a time that was a sacrificial seed for us because he was changing jobs and things were a little bit uncertain. But we both felt compelled that this is what we needed to do, was to sow into our church, you know, and we would reap the benefits, not just us financially, but to sow seed all over. I mean, we're given so that we can give to others, so that we can help others. But it was a sacrificial seed for us, and God blessed us mightily for it.
And Pastor Joel said something that really hit home with me is, when we come to the church on Sundays, we should expect something. And now I do come expectingly, walk boldly in here, and praise and worship our God with everyone else, and take that back out into the world. And it's true. Everything we touch and everything we do is blessed, and everything that we set our eyes upon bears fruit for us and for the community and the people around us. And that's the best, I believe, one of the best testimonies we can have for this church and for Jesus Christ.
The Bridge Church, en inglés y ahora en español. The Bridge Church, el puente que te lleva a la presencia de Dios. The Bridge Church, una iglesia bendiciendo durante 7 años a nuestra ciudad en inglés y ahora en español, comenzando el 30 de septiembre. The Bridge Church. Infórmate al 361-767-9302. It's a new day.